Just two little cherries under on a little cherry branch. And I think it cost about 70 bucks. Probably took about 30 minutes, 40 minutes. I still have the tattoo to this day, but it's one of my only ones I've kept from the start. I think I went back 2 days later and got another two tattoos. I couldn't help myself. I was hooked straight away, instantly hooked. I've never felt labelled in any way, really badly for being tattooed. I've never had any bad experiences or anything. And to me, I mean, I don't have anything super bad on the front of my face, and that's where you tell your story. The rest of it, if you can't prove to someone you're a nice person by having tattoos, you probably shouldn't have got it in the first place. I don't feel labelled or judged by it in any way. I feel more like people want to know more. They want to ask, you know, why'd you get that, and what does it mean, and... like, as much as those questions are annoying to answer for the 500,000th time, they're still good questions. And to me, it's sort of something you got to wear on the chin. And I get to educate people. For my birthday 1 year, my brother told me that there was a parcel coming in the mail. I remember getting there and it being this big box taped up. And then I opened the box and I seen what he'd sent me, and why on earth have you sent me this? And I called him. I was like, he's like, did you get your present? I said, yeah, you bought me the tattoo equipment. Why? And he was like, because I'm sick of paying for them. So hurry up and learn how to do it. And that was pretty much what kickstarted me to a decade later still be tattooing. The first person I ever tattooed with that equipment was my best mate, Harry Mad Dog. I did like this rose. I think it looked like it's just like a butchered red cabbage by the end of it. It was not a good looking tattoo. It's now being happily covered up, but that was like the first thing I ever did, and just the daunting feeling of having no idea whatsoever of what I was doing or what I was trying to achieve in the moment, but just being stuck in the whim and having the balls to actually go with it. I did it, and it was a bad looking cabbage. He had quite a few tattoos off me that I'd done in my kitchen and in my, you know, my back room at my old house. And the owner of the shop walked out, and he was wide eyed, and he said to the guy that I was with, like, who does your tattoos? And he went bright red in the face and sort of pointed at me and said that he doesn't. And he asked me if I was a tattooist, and I said, no. I said, I just want to be. And he just looked me dead in the eyes and asked, can you start tomorrow at 4 o'clock? I've got room. I need someone to come and fill a shift. And I called my work that I was currently cleaning toilets at the time. Called my work, and I just quit my job that day, and I started tattooing. I'd already been tattooing from home for almost 2 years. And as I said, just learning the wrong thing completely. And then, yeah, one opportunity, and I just took it and ran with it as hard as I could. Knowing that what you're doing is there forever. You literally got to draw a picture or replicate a photo with a vibrating brick in your hand. You know, it's not an easy job, but it becomes a passion, and I think that's when it becomes not so much a hard, but like something you're trying to achieve each time. You're leaving a forever imprint on someone. And if you're not trying to do your absolute best, better than the last one you did every single tattoo, then you're probably in the wrong industry. The luxury with tattooing is that you never stop learning. Like every day, every single time you tattoo, every time you pick up a pencil, every time someone asks for something unique you've never drawn before, you're constantly challenging yourself and bettering yourself. You know, you're never gonna be content. You're never gonna be to a point where you're like, okay, I'm a tattooist now, I've made it. Like, you may have made the claim of being able to call yourself a tattoo artist, but doesn't mean it's finished. You know, it never stops, you never stop learning. And I think that's the best thing. You constantly grow, your art constantly grows with you. So it's a good little path to be on. Thank you. I personally feel like every tattoo I've ever done has gotten better than the last one. And I feel like when the day that stops, it's probably the day I'll stop tattooing and find something else to do. Something a bit more basic, a bit more less stressful.